What's up, dirt nerds? I'm George, and it is Dirt 30. Let's see what we're going to be digging into today. What's up, dirt nerds? Big day today. 300 subscribers. We've actually hit it last night or yesterday, I believe. So, thank you, everybody. This is an awesome community, as always. I love you all. This has just been an absolute hoot for me. So, I want to contribute and give back to my subscribers and my viewers, and I have I got a lot to cover today, so I just wanted to throw that first part out there that it will be announced. I will be doing a giveaway, and all the details will come at the end of this video. So first and foremost, I got a bunch of mail call shout outs I want to get done. Then we'll get to all the fun stuff, the prizes and whatnot. So, first and foremost, I'm going to start off with some mail calls and shout-outs. Ginger in Japan. Wonderful guy. I mentioned him on my last Pay Dirt video as being a Pay Dirt reviewer and whatnot. He is a soldier. And like I had mentioned, he was stationed in Bahrain. I hope I'm pronouncing that properly. And he had saved some currency for me. Or just had some sitting around, and he sent it over to me and said, you know, hey, I got a gift for you. So he sent it along, and let me show you real quick what we got. There's a bunch of coins and a bill. The bill is awesome. So I'm trying to get through this as quick as I can, because again, a lot to do. So there is one half dinar from Bahrain. Again, I don't really know how to speak Arabic, so I don't know what it says other than that. Central Bank of Bahrain, half dinar. And that is just a cool, cool bill. I mean, come on, look at all that. That is a cool bill. So that will go into the currency collection for me. And a bunch of coins. Really cool stuff here. Alright, so let's see what we got. I think there was like a couple of each, so let me break it down here. So 2010 and a 2009. I believe that's 100 dinar coins. Yeah, try to get them focused. There we go. Pretty cool coins there. See the 100 on the back there. 100 dinars or whatever they are. Again, I don't speak Arabic, so just kind of guessing on what that says. And let's see, there was this one, is a one of these ones, and it's a 2009 50 dinar. Let me, come on camera, there you go. And it's 2009, that's a 50. And there was two tens. Let's see, it was 2003 or is that 2005? I think that's a 5 here. I got my scope up. Let me cheat. That's 2005. And a 2014. And those are both 10s. Let me show you those here. Kingdom of Bahrain. The old palm tree. Probably some desert underneath it, I imagine. And there's two of these little guys. Let's see, those are the... And then I got... Oh, that's right. Almost forgot that one. There's a 25. There we go. See it a little better there. Not sure what's going on there. Some interesting pictures on these. I'm always fascinated by these foreign coins, some of the images on them, especially the ones that you can't read the language, so you have no idea what's going on. But there's a couple of fives. Let's see, what were those? And again, a 2005 and a 2015. The 15 is really shiny. It is really pretty. Here you go. Come on. There you go. There's the fives. Let me flip them around here, show you the palm trees. Here you go. Those are so pretty. Way cool, way cool. Thank you, Ginger in Japan. Those are some beautiful coins. Everybody, please go check out his channel. Watch all the great things that he does. They say he does Pater reviews, does prospecting in a sake barrel, which is just completely cool to watch. I know he does all kinds of other things too. I'm trying to, sorry, you know, my brain doesn't always work when I need it to. But yeah, go check him out. He does really good job with his Pater reviews. And I know he's got some other videos up, and you go, it'll come to me later. But anyway, go check out Ginger in Japan. Great dude. Great videos. And he's a soldier and he's out in Japan right now. When I first met him, he was stationed in Bahrain. So, and hopefully he does not have to go back to the desert anytime soon. He'd stay over in Japan. It's nice there. All right, moving on. So this one I received from Mary Love, another wonderful lady out here in the coin community. Kind of a quick shout out for Mary Love. This is more towards the channel that I was actually on. It's a young man. His channel is Currency Hunter 88. He's a young dude, and he was having a live stream and trying to do something cool for his viewers, but you know, because he is a young kid, his parents will not allow him to ship anything out or receive anything to their address. They're not okay with that. So Mary Love decided that she would go ahead and do a giveaway for him, and you know, so you know, I'm pretty sure it was guess what year or something the next wheat centers. That he finds was going to be, and I guessed the right year. And Mary Love sent me a 1968D 40% Kennedy half dollar. Pretty good condition. 40% silver. I love me silver. So everybody, please go check out Currency Hunter 88. He's a young kid, and I always encourage the youth of today to get into this. I mean, come on, this is an easy investment for your future, and it's not hard to do. It's not hard to go searching through coin rolls, and it's really not hard to put this aside and just not spend it. Just forget it's there. So again, thank you, Mary Love. That was an awesome gift, and that was a great thing for you to do for that young man. And everybody, please go check out Currency Hunter 88. And give him a subscribe, give him a like, watch his videos. He gets on, does live streams as too, which is pretty awesome. I love when kids get on and do this. So again, Mary Love and Currency Hunter 88, thank you very much. You are awesome people. Folks, please go check them out as well. All right, next up, Miss Coddington, Miss Beth Coddington. This is one of the coolest ladies in the coin community. You're all awesome. I love you all. But Miss Beth is so neat. She is so fun to watch. When she gets on and does her live streams, her laugh is so infectious. You can't help but smile and be happy and joyful whenever you're watching her streams. So, I love getting on and just hanging out with Miss Beth. She gets on a lot of the other channels that I'm on as well, like Ken Peavy's channel, when he does, you know, on some of their Lemonhead Penny. She loves snatching up on some of them good deals on those coin auctions that they have on the live streams. And don't bet against Miss Beth. If she's up there, she wants that coin, she's going to get that coin. But anyway, she was doing one of her live streams, and again, I was hanging out in chat, and she did a giveaway to chat. And I'm pretty sure it was a random number, you know, just, she says, you know, between 1 and 3, and then hits the little go button, it pops up on the screen, and then everybody just gets a guess. Some people, sometimes, like Klesh Guitars, he'll do, you know, guess as many times as you want, go. But I believe Miss Beth was, you know, one guess, one number, just something like that. I don't remember what it was. It was a guess the number, and I guessed the number. And it was four. And again, I love these things. I'm pretty sure this was from 1959. Yeah. It is a Alaskan state token. Here, I'll take it out of there so you can see it. Take that glare away. Take away my face. There we go. 49th state, 1959, Alaska. Let me show you the other side here. It says good for $1 in trade all year during when Alaska became. This is a kind of hard. I'm trying to read it backwards, so. Any cooperative business or redeemable at face value at the I can't read it backward at the Fairbanks Chamber of Commerce. Yeah, done trying to read it backwards. How cool is that? An Alaska state token. That's awesome. I didn't have any state tokens before, so that's a good start to a new collection for me. So I dig it. Thank you, Miss Coddington. Everybody, again, please go check out Beth Coddington. Go check out her channel. Give her a subscribe. Give her a like. Just go watch her streams. You won't be disappointed, and you will most definitely give her a thumbs up, give her a subscribe, because she is just a very cool lady, and she is so fun to watch. She has so much fun on her streams, and whenever she's in chat on another channel, she's always very nice and joking around with everybody. She's very kind-hearted and just a wonderful person. So, thank you, Beth Coddington. That was awesome. All right. Next. All right. So, as always, Mantic Coins, one of my favorites. I love these folks. Their streams are awesome. They're always the most entertaining stream of them all because you get to play games. And I love their games. Their games are so much fun. And hanging out in their chats, even if I can't donate that night, I'll hang out in chat just to play the games. And they even have Mantics Anonymous for those of us who can't stop playing the games. Adriana will come on and stream for an hour or so just for us addicts who can't stop. And it's all we do is we just play games. So, but I got onto one of their live streams the other day again, and I did a donation. It wasn't a huge donation, but everything counts, and they're more than happy, and they always take care of you with your donation. So I'm pretty sure it was a $10 donation, and I got an NIFC 2017, and I got a 67 Kennedy 40%er, and I was also again hanging out in chat, and I won one of the midstream giveaways. I won a 1/10 ounce. It's not gonna zoom. Oh, this plastic sucks. I'm gonna have to take it out. And I know, no gloves. I'm terrible. I'm gonna slide it onto my pants and just hold the edges here, just so as not to mess it up too much. I like keeping these shiny and pretty. All right, here we go. See if I can make that work. Come on, yeah. Oh, the light keeps trying to take it away. It won't focus. My macro sucks. This phone is not the greatest for filming, but it kind of works. Anyway, it's just a little tiny coin. It's kind of hard to see everything, so there she is. Kinda. Anyway, 1/10 ounce round, pure silver. That is beautiful. And I love Mantic Coins. Their show is just so entertaining. Shay is very informative. If you ever have questions or you want to know anything about coins, like any denomination, he's right there. I mean, the man knows a lot. There's a lot of folks on here that I highly recommend to watch just because if you're into coins or you want to learn more about it, there's so much to learn. But Shay helps out tremendously. Adriana is an awesome lady. She is very entertaining and very knowledgeable herself. So their streams are always just, they're a hoot. The folks that hang out there are just cool. Everybody has fun. So go check out Mantic Coins. Go get on there and hunt some rolls if you can, if you can donate. If not, just get on there, hang out, chat, play games. You get a chance to win stuff just for hanging out, playing games and chat. So you don't even have to pay. Just be there and show your love, show your support for the channel. All right, and last up for this part, we've got Ray's World. I love Ray's World. We need more folks from here. All my dirt nerds, all my coin nerds, if you haven't, get on to Ray's World. Go check him out. He's cool. His streams are growing more and more, which is awesome. He hunts nickel rolls every Saturday. Every Saturday that he can. He has all kinds of other things that he does. He's involved with church and helping out with his community as well. He does beekeeping, and I'm still really anxiously waiting to see what some of the results are. I'm hoping to see the bees doing very well. I'm sure they are. I really can't wait to see him pull some honey out of there. So I was on his stream the other day. I believe I only was able to donate a little bit, but again, I can't remember if I won a giveaway or if this was found in my roll. But either way, it came from Ray's World. It's a 1947 Canadian nickel. A little beaver nickel. Ah, come on. He's not going to focus. I'm not in the screen. There it goes. And there's a dude on the back. Used to seeing a queen on the back of the Canadians, but that's pretty cool. But thank you, Ray's World. Another addition to my wonderful Canadian coin collection. Right down there. All right. So everybody, again, go check out Ray's World. I'm starting to see more and more folks popping in on there that I see on all the other channels that I usually go to. So that's really awesome. Hopefully some of my videos and my shout outs are helping generate some of those new viewers. If not, then get your butt over there. Go check it out. Ray's World is awesome. It's $3 a roll, $10 for 5 rolls, and he'll hunt the nickels for you. And he'll set aside anything Canadian, foreign. He's looking for buffaloes, war nickels. There's specific years that he does hang out that he will pull aside and keep for you as well. And he'll send all that to you. And it's a great time. He's a fun dude. He does a very good job with his streams. He knows what he's talking about. He knows what he's doing. If you, again, have any questions about the coins that we're searching and looking through, he'll be more than happy to respond to you and let you know, hey, this is what it is. Here's what you're looking for. This is what we're doing. Like that grease error deal with the two, I believe it's the 2016 nickels. With a strike through grease error. I had no idea what the heck that was, and I kept seeing that same deal with those nickels. They were just very, you know, it's a brand new nickel, and the thing looks like it's been ran through a lawnmower. You know, I mean, just like, or sandpaper. Like, the thing is just, there's no detail left. That thing is so almost blank. It's like, what? It's a brand new nickel. So anyway, go check out Ray's World. Go get on there. Go hunt some nickel rolls with Ray. You won't be disappointed. I think that's like the smallest I've ever got from him, and I think I only, you know, bought like 2 rolls. So out of the 2 rolls, I got a cool 47 Canadian nickel. So I don't think I've really been skunked yet. Like I said, he always finds something. There's always something good in rolls of nickels. You know, even if it's just an old nickel, it may not be silver, but it's still old. You know, if it's over 50 years, to me, if it's over 50 years old, that's cool. That's worth hanging on to, because that's older than me. So, I dig anything old, as far as coins and currency, or foreign, or whatever. So, one last quick shout-out. Actually goes to my daughter. She did her senior trip. She went to Mexico. kind of had a little debacle there, but that was to deal with customs and everything. Thanks, Trump. Anyway, she brought me home a couple coins. You know, she was trying to bring me home more, but again, customs, there was issues, and yeah. But funny enough, while she was in Mexico, she found me a Hawaiian token. Let's see if I can get her to focus. Come on. There we go. How cool is that? From a Hawaiian token in Mexico. Not sure what that was. I'm pretty well, it's about the same size as these whatever these ones are. 10 pesos. Oh, $10. 10 peso. $10 pesos. 10 pesos. 2018. It's about the same size as that there, so I imagine that's probably what it came as. And then there was a 2010. 10 pesos. Way more faded out center. Like, that thing is just gone. But that is a cool, beautiful coin that my daughter brought back for me. And a couple of $1 pesos. A couple of 1 pesos is a 1. It's 2016 and a 2015. 1 peso. Beautiful little coins. Oop. Now it's got a scratch on it. Alright, so that was just a quick little shout out for my daughter there. That was her trip to Mexico for her senior trip thing. So that was, you know, what I requested. I was like, you know, if you want to bring me back a souvenir, coins, bills, currency, anything like that, you know, I like the foreign money. So, you know, coins was the big thing. I was like, just bring me back a couple coins. That's all I ask for. Don't need no tequila. I don't drink. Don't need a sombrero. I don't nap. All right, everybody. Let's get to the fun stuff. Let me pause you 1 second. I'll bring it right around. Show you some cool stuff. All right. Just some quick additions I wanted to show you to the coin corner here. I went on to eBay. Won a few auctions. This display case, actually, I picked this up from my work, from where I work at the Goodwill. Got it for $6. And is the... There we go, I'll show you the badge first. America's Historic Silver Liberty Coins. So it's all the, pretty much all the main Liberty silver coins. You know, as you see, it's got a spot for all the main ones. It's got the Seated Liberty Half Dime, the Seated Liberty Dime, the Barber Dime, and then the Mercury's. It's got spots for the Seated Liberty Half Dollar, the Standing Liberty Quarter, which you can see I got one, yay. The Barber Quarter, which I got one from Grandpa's Hall the other day, in his little treasure chest. The Seated Liberty Quarter Dollar, which you can see I don't have one of those yet either. And then up here is the Peace Dollars. And I got the one that was donated to me from Big Flip, and then the one from Grandpa in there for the Peace Dollars. And my Morgan, that's my Morgan, that's the only Morgan I got. I've had her for a very, very, very long time. She's been with me, oh, since I was little, in many ways. Lots of stories behind that dollar, too much to go into now, kind of a little personal. And then it's got the Walking Liberty Half Dollar spot. Here's one that I picked up from eBay. I won that on auction for $14.50. It's not in bad condition. It's got a little ding on the rim right there, but it looks like she's been cleaned, polished, you know, she's been shined up a bit. So, don't really care. I didn't have one at the time that I won the auction, so I needed to have one to fill my spot there. And then if you go back and watch the Grandpa's Treasure Chest video, the parking meter lamp, those were
Those were in there. Those were grandpa's. And then the at the Morgan, or was it the not the Morgan, the barber, $0.50. And I had a couple of those. One that I got from Mantic, and one that I got from Klesch Guitars. And then the two that were in Grandpa's treasure chest. So I got those spots filled. So I got a decent little start to my little Liberty silver collection. And it's even got a little drawer down here to put extra stuff, and that's where I got just some regular silver quarters. Those are from Grandpa's. Those are the V nickels. And then the Buffaloes. I haven't put those in the cases yet. So, not too bad. And then I picked these up. These were not an auction. These were just a purchase. I think I got them for like $9.98 each. But it's the 84 proof set and a 91 proof set. The purple box. Those are very, very pretty. And one of them, I'm trying to remember which one here. Yeah, see if I can focus on this. This is going to be tough. I don't know if it'll do it. That penny has an error. Kind of see it, that big blob right below God. Between God and Lincoln's head. Yeah, there's a great big, I'm pretty sure it looks like a die crack. But my loop, the batteries in my loop died, and it's not strong enough to see. Otherwise, with my scope, I can kind of see it, but the glare is too much. But you can see there's a big old chode right in there, right underneath God, right behind his head. And that is a brand new proof set. So that was kind of cool. I like finding an error on a proof set. Those are supposed to be quality controlled and checked. And then this one was an auction that I won. I'm pretty sure it was an auction. It was for a 2001 50 state quarter proof set, and it's only five of the states. As you can see, it's just one little box. It's only five of the states: New York, North Carolina, Rhode Island, Vermont, and Kentucky. Beautiful sets of coins. I got four of the exact same set. And I can't remember what I paid for. It was really cheap. I think it was only like $10 or something like that. I want it for a very decent price. So, what I'm going to do with those, I'm keeping one for myself. My oldest son, believe it or not, said he would like to hang on to one. Because I offered them all to my kids first. And all but one said that, nah, that's cool, but nah. So, my oldest is keeping one. I'm keeping one. The other two are going to go to you folks out here. So I've got two 2001 proof sets that I'll be adding to my stack of giveaway stuff to do for giveaway videos. Now for the fun part. Let me set you down. Let me flip you around. And let's get on to this giveaway. Be right back, Dirt Nerds. Dirt Nerds, here we go. So, for the final part of the video here, I'm going to show you what all the prize is going to be. It's going to be one prize. One person wins it all. We'll draw a second place name, only in the event that the first place does not contact me back, or for whatever reason, you know, I need to draw a second person, I'll have a second person drawn. That second person will get a guaranteed prize, so no matter what, both names drawn will receive a gift. In the event that the first person does not reply, or for whatever reason I cannot give them the gift, obviously, runner-up takes his place. And then I will go ahead, just because, I will draw another name, and it, after that, you know, I'll run another video saying, hey, you know, it happened, and I'll do a third runner-up, or a second runner-up, whatever. I'll do another runner-up and give away whatever I was going to give to this runner-up. So, here we go.
start off with, as always, Dirt Nerd. Got to have your Dirt 30 Dirt Nerd sticker. So that will be included in both packs for the runner-up and for the grand prize. And there's the sticker for the there, and there's a sticker for there. So I'm setting up the prize pack as I'm going here. First place prize receiver will get your choice. Now, keep in mind, these were all found roll hunting. I found these all in my very first roll hunt. So there are imperfections. These are not perfect, uncirculated, untouched. You know, they've been touched. Somebody touched them. They put them in rolls. I put them into these little cases wearing gloves. So my prints are not on them. Well, except for the case. I'll touch this part. I'm going to touch it all over. And you'll have my DNA on there anyway. So, but the coin itself is clean as when I found it. So there is flaws, there is imperfections. Oh well. So, your choice. It is a bicentennial. Now, I have one from each mint. One is a proof. Get my hand here. There we go, there you are. Come on, focus on the coin, not me. There you go. So that one's a proof. That is the S Mint, obviously. Beautiful mirror finish on these things. They are gorgeous. And if they're not the proof, they are the business strike, and pretty much there is marks, but these are really beautiful coins. And here is the 76D. Focus on the coin, not me. There we go. There's the 76D, and it is in beautiful condition. There are some marks because these were circulated. They were found roll hunting. But they are in very good condition. This one actually kind of takes on a very light gold tone to it too. So, sorry, I keep trying to see it myself. There we go. There is a very slight gold toning to it. It is very pretty. Now this one, kind of odd. There is some marks on the neck, and there is a weird, almost looks like he's blowing out a chooch. So there's a little fog on his face. I'm not sure what kind of error that is, but like I said, these are dang near uncirculated. See if I can catch the right light and show you the little marks. There is right here on his neck, there is some marking, and right there on his cheek, there's a little mark. Again, like I said, these were circulated. But I don't think for very much or very long. There you go. Now you can see the little... Looks like he's blowing out a chooch. There's like a little fog on the front of the coin there. I don't know if that's a lamb error or if it's struck through grease or whatever it is. That is just a weird fog on the front of the coin. Maybe it's that milk staining everybody's talking about. I don't know. Coin noob. But anyway, so I have one of each mint for the bicentennial, and this side of this coin is actually, come on camera, focus on the coin, not me, there we go, there she is. So these are all very, very nice coins. They're ones that I thought were well enough to hang on to and to put into one of these little thingies. So again, I am a coin noob. I may have just put a worthless turd into a wrapper and said, here you go, cool. But so far, everybody that I've shown these to has been like, yeah, those are some pretty nice coins. Those are worth hanging on to and covering up. So, especially that proof. That thing is beautiful. Nice deep cameo. Just give me that mirror on there. You can almost shave right in that thing. So, you'll get your choice of one of those three. You do not get all three. You will get your choice of one of the three. Just one. That leaves me open to give away these ones later. So, you'll get your choice of one of those to go along with your Dirt Nerd sticker. The runner-up, where did I put it? I set it aside. Where did he go? There he is. Will receive a 2013 and IFC in a, again, very, very clean condition. It was circulated. It was found in those rolls as well. But it is super, super sharp. Very clean. And it's an NAFC, so that automatically right there makes it worth putting into the little case. So there you will receive your 2013, and there's actually a little bit of toning starting to go just right around the edge of the coin. So it's a little bit of a gold tone, probably from being in somebody's book, because I'm pretty sure, like I said, these had to have been from somebody's collection, and somebody just popped them out and turned them into the bank for 50 cents a piece. So you'll receive your Dirt Nerd sticker. That's going to be the runner-up gift right there. The runner-up gift will receive the sticker and that NIFC in very, very good condition. Almost uncirculated. I'd definitely say AU. Again, coin noob, but I'm pretty sure that's an AU. Continuing on. So first prize, choice of one of the three proofs, or one of the three bicentennials, and the Dirt Nerd sticker. You will also receive, because I do want to count my Dirt Nerds in on this one, not just my coin nerds, I put together a small assortment of crystals from my personal collection. Nice big chunky top with a little side crystal on it. This one actually, believe it or not, if you hold it to the right light or put a white backing on it, there is a slight amethyst ghost in the tip. There is a very light purple coloring in the tip of this crystal. There's a little bad boy here. She doesn't look like a whole lot. Okay, I'm not going to be able to focus in on that. But right inside here, just inside the face of that facet, there she goes, I can sparkle on it. Look at that. That is a piece of pyrite inside that crystal. It's not a big one. It's a nice, decent crystal. It actually has a point to it, kind of. And these are all dirty. I will tell you this. These are not polished. These are not cleaned. Short of just a little soap and water and a very, very soft, old, wore-out toothbrush to knock off the extra mud and clay just so I can see what's inside. So there is that one. And then you'll receive this little cluster piece here. Very nice point on the top with a nice little bunch on the bottom. Okay, and then this other just nice little clustery piece, all kinds of points and color and craziness going on in this chunk. So just another one of my personal picks that I held onto in my own little goodie bag. So you'll receive those four crystals along with the sticker and the coin. You'll receive a 2001 state quarter proof set, the five quarters, New York, North Carolina, Rhode Island, Vermont, and Kentucky. Let me show you. There is the COA is included in the box. These are all certified. Here's the paperwork. And here is the proof set you will receive. This is the exact set that you will receive. I will not switch out. I just want to make sure I'm focusing here. I'm hoping you all see this because I can't see it because I'm completely blocking my phone. So I hope you can see it as well. I hope it's shining nice and bright for you. I'll find out in editing. So that's included in the first place prize pack. Now, for my Dirt Nerds, this is especially for my Dirt Nerds. You get your choice, because I had this, I'm waiting on this gentleman's mail to arrive so that I can give him his shout out and do his video as well. I'm going to be including, I will be, sorry, technical error there. I said something I shouldn't have. So, I will be including a quarter gram of gold This is very, very fine, fine gold. Now, your choice. I can leave it in that nice little pretty vial, just as it is. Or, I can make some dirt nerd dirt. I can throw together a nice bag of little concentrates from my collection bucket and throw that gold into the dirt and let you enjoy the experience of finding it yourself. Or I can just leave it in the vial and you can just go, oh, cool, I got some gold. Or you can pan it yourself and see if you can recover the gold just as I did. So I'll leave that up to the winner. There is a quarter gram of fine gold. There is a few little grains of black sand in there too, possibly some bits of silver even maybe. So it is actually over a quarter gram, a little bit, just to compensate for the black sand and the possible grains of silver that may be in there as well. So that is also going to the first place winner. Now, because this is kind of a big mark for me, and this is kind of a big deal with this prize pack, I am going to let this prize, or sorry, they're going to let this giveaway run for a little bit longer than normal. I usually do 1 week. I'm going to let it go for 2 weeks. And it will be same as always, random comment generated. You may comment as many times as you like, as long as there is someone else's comment in between your comments. So you cannot spam the comments with just back-to-back, guess, you know. You gotta wait and let somebody else get in before you can put your next comment in. As long as there's one person in between each of your comments. If you have successive comments, I will delete your excessive comments. I will not completely remove you. You will not be booted from the contest. But if you spam the comments, your excess comments will be deleted and you'll be reduced to one in between each other's comments. So, this is open to everybody, not just the United States. I am welcoming everybody to jump in, join in. Same rules apply as before. If you live in a country that will not allow me to send you American currency, silver, gold, all that fun stuff, that is on you to make sure before you enter my contest. If you cannot receive the gift and I go to send it to you and they say, no, sorry, you cannot send that stuff to this country, then I will have to let you know that I'm sorry, I cannot do it. I'm kind of figuring out ways to make it happen so that everything works, so that there's no issues, but this will be a pretty nasty little customs forms to fill out for me, so all my folks overseas, please make sure that you can receive this package so that I'm not wasting all this time and effort with customs and dealing with these forms. I mean, sorry. You folks are never a waste of time or effort. So, I will do my due diligence to make sure that you can receive this package as well. But please make sure before you enter that you can enter. So, the other thing is please make sure that if you are under the age of 18 that you have your parents' permission to enter this contest. Otherwise, I will have to say, sorry, I cannot give it to you because you are under the age of 18. As per always, per YouTube regulations, YouTube is not responsible for this giveaway or any part of it therein. I am doing this solely on my own dollar, my own dime, my own time. This is something I'm doing to say thank you to all of you folks out there for being so kind and generous to me. It's my turn and my time to return the favor. So I'm doing this. And that's how we do it. All right, dirt nerds. I'm going to try and get a pay dirt in. Mother Nature may be opening up for me here and showing me some sunshine, so I might get out and go pan me some dirt. I'll do a video of that as well. I may not upload it immediately. Might wait a day because I got today off, but I'm working tomorrow. Tomorrow will be Saturday. Today's Friday. Happy Friday, everybody. So depending on when this uploads, because this is obviously a long, long, long video for me, longer than usual, just because I had so much to do, so much to talk about, so much to show you, and so much appreciation and love to give you all. So yeah, this is just going to be a long one. If it, as long as it uploads tonight, cool. Doesn't matter. The contest, pretty much, I'm counting it as starting on Saturday, even though this will be up tonight. The contest starts once the video uploads. But as far as time frame, 2 weeks from Saturday, midnight, will be the end. So, I don't have a calendar in front of me, so I don't know the exact date is when that will be. But it will be in the description below. Please check and read all description, contest rules, everything in the description below. Go check out the links in the description below. Go check out everybody that has been mentioned today. Mary Love, Currency Hunter 88, Mantic Coins, as always, Ray's World, as always, my two favorite folks, Ginger in Japan, great dude, I love you, sir. Thank you for your service, and thank you for those coins. That was awesome. Who am I forgetting? Beth Coddington. Thank you, Beth. Miss Beth, you are awesome. You're a lovely lady. Thank you again for that awesome token. Anybody else I forgot that I haven't said? You know who you all are. I love you all. SJ's Mixed Adventures, Ken Peavy, Klesh Guitars, Diggin' 606, everybody, I love you all. Wish I could give everybody shout-outs. You know, Golden Pater Reviews, go get you some AU's Finest. Dylan Miller, Miller Prospecting, go check out his Pater Reviews. Everybody, you know, I'm not going to put all the links to all those folks in there. You know, you can check out my people who I've subscribed to. You can go and see everything that I don't have anything hidden. It's all open for everybody to see. Go check out everybody that I've subscribed to. And you'll see, I most of them are some pretty cool folks. I've got a lot of new subscribers, a lot of new folks coming in, checking me out. And I appreciate every one of you. Thank you. Love you all, Dirt Nerds. Have a great night, great day, great evening. Go hunt some rolls, go swing a detector, go dig in the dirt. Whatever you got to do to get your treasures, go get out and do it. Night, everybody.